Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So today I want to share with you the update for version 1.4 of the shader library. So once you've installed the download, all you need to do is go to the 3D view and press the N key, which will bring up the sidebar here. And then if we scroll down, we can find the shader library. So there's a few minor improvements in this update. One of them being is a suggestion that one of you guys had, and that was to display the color in the solid shading mode. For example, if we previously added a shader, it just would stay grey like this. So if we open Metallics, make sure we have an object selected, and then go ahead and click Gold. Now we can see it's more of a gold colour, and we can tell the difference between this one and if we duplicate this. Just move it over. Let's say, for example, we change this colour to silver. Now we can see the difference between the colours. And of course, this doesn't affect the rendering, it's just for the viewport. Same thing when you define a new colour. Click OK, it will then be the colour that you selected. So again, it's not really a big improvement, it's something small, but hopefully you guys find that helpful. The next thing I wanted to show you is the new addition, which is the materials tab. So right now there's only one material, which is the leather material. So I'm just going to get rid of these. Let's Shift A, add in a sphere. So I'm just going to bring up the search operator here. For me, it's spacebar, but for you, it may be something else depending on your key configuration. But here, I'm just going to type shade smooth and then hit shade smooth. There we go. So now if we click this button here, it'll bring up an operator, which we can define a color. And by default, it looks quite dark, but if we hit OK, and here in the viewport, it looks quite dark. But when we render this, it'll be a lot brighter. So if you want to see the true color, just go to the material tab here. Open the preview and you can see this is the color that it's actually going to be. So I'm just going to switch this over to the rendered view. There we go. So you can see it's a procedurally generated material, this kind of leather. It's very basic and it can be tweaked if you want to change it. If you're not happy with the color that you selected, you can always click this and just change the color. Maybe a cream color. I don't know, something like that. Again, you guys have creative license to change this to any color that you want. So yeah, for now, the materials tab only has one shader, which is this leather shader. Hopefully I can add some more materials to this. And again, if you guys have any suggestions on what you want to see, or if you have any links to materials you want me to add to the shader, then go ahead and let us know in the comments below. If you want to download this add-on, there'll be a link in the description to our blog. You can go ahead and download this. But I hope you find this update helpful. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching. Stay safe and I'll see you next time.